essay, I chose Susan B. Anthony to write about. The title of my paragraphs is The Impact of One Woman. Susan grew up as a very independent girl, and later, on November 1st, 1872, Susan B. Anthony, like many Americans, registered to vote. Prior to this election, Anthony had been promoting the Women's Suffrage Bill, which addressed women's equality with men. On November 5th that year, she joined with many Americans and cast her ballot. But unlike the many other voters, she was later arrested by deputy United States Marshals because they said it was illegal for women to vote. Susan B. Anthony was born on February 15, 1820, in Adams, Massachusetts. And she grew with a loving Quaker family. Susan was the second eldest of eight children, and her parents, Daniel and Lucy Anthony, owned a cotton mill. Throughout all her childhood, which was almost 200 years ago, women wore many layers, such as dresses and smocks. Yes, it's true, girls. They didn't wear blue jeans or shorts or even pants. They wore many layers and were not, and because they wore so many layers, it was hard to skip, run, jump, and play games with other children. Sometimes, people would blatantly scold girls for laughing loudly or shouting. Naturally, Susan grew up as a Quaker girl. She did not wear any bright colors, only gray and black. During the year 1826, Susan and her family moved to Batterville, New York, because of her father bought a larger cotton mill. This was also the time when she went to study at a Quaker school in Philadelphia. Susan's father, being a scholarly man, believed that women should be educated to work and provide for themselves. At age 10, Susan's mother enrolled her in a winter school. The winter school had a male schoolmaster to keep the boys focused. Susan was interested in education and would do anything to learn more. Later, Susan's father's mill failed, and she had to return from her schooling to help provide for her family. Because the Quaker faith permitted women to teach and preach, she had many job opportunities to teach where Susan lived with her family in New York. In the year 1852, Susan B. Anthony met her future partner in the women's suffrage rights for the first time, Mrs. Elizabeth Cady Stanton. Later, they began to work together on the subject of women's suffrage. They also found the NWSA, National Women's Suffrage of America, which inspired Susan to educate people mostly through speeches across the nation. 1854 was the year she started the Married Women's Property Rights petition, which made Miss Anthony realize that in order for women to have any rights to anything, they must vote. Because of her recent realization that same year, she made her main goal to find a way to give women the rights to vote. Willingly, Susan called the first women's suffrage convention in Washington, D.C. in 1869. Did you know that she was arrested for voting in 1872? She was fined for $100, but she didn't pay it, no sir. Sadly, Susan B. Anthony died in 1906, and women still could not vote, but her spirit lived on because other young and old women came together and because they stood up for one another, the law was passed. In 1920, they celebrated that women's suffrage had opened hope of ending when the law had been passed for women to vote over the age of 21. Since 1920, which was exactly 100 years after Susan B. Anthony's birth, men and women have enjoyed more equality under American law to engage in any occupation, study issues, and land ownership. Before Susan B. Anthony, women could not vote. Because of her impact, our lives have been changed forever. One little paper changed so much in such a big way. Women have the power to vote. Women have a voice. Women now have the power of having options. They can have the choice on what they will do with their lives, whether it's a career of raising a family, they can choose a career or who they would like to lead our country. Even with all her confidence as a young woman and her determination, Susan B. Anthony was not successful in securing the right to women the vote. However, due to her efforts and the efforts of other women, her contemporaries, in 1920, the United States Congress adopted the 19th Amendment, which is said to grant women the constitutional right to vote. Thank you for listening.